Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about what the bisection method is and how you can use this method to solve for the roots of a nonlinear function. The bisection method is a method for solving nonlinear equations and nonlinear systems of equations. If you remember from our previous video, we stated that solving a nonlinear function means to find the roots, that is, where the function passes through the x-axis. So let's talk about the procedure for solving for the roots of a nonlinear function using the bisection method. In this video, we will not be solving an actual problem. This video is just meant for the theory and the steps behind the bisection method. In the next video, we will solve for a problem using the bisection method in numerous ways. So let's get right into the procedure. So let's say we have a function that looks like this. Step 1, we define a region, two x values, for which we know that there is a root present. But how do we know this? Well, our first input of x, which we will call a here, will have either a positive or a negative output. Well, whatever output we receive from our output of input a, we want the output from input b to be the opposite. This ensures that our function crossed the x-axis. One way of validating this is multiplying the two outputs together, as one needs to be positive and one needs to be a negative value. The product of these two outputs will never be greater than 0. Now, step 2. We find the middle of our previous two inputs and we'll define a new point in the middle. We can do this by adding input A and B together and then dividing by 2. This value will be our new midpoint value. Now, we can apply the previously talked about output product test. So, we take the output of input A times the output of input C and see if the product of these two values is less than 0. If so, that ensures the root is to the left of our midpoint C. If the product of output A and C are positive, then we either have two negative outputs or two positive outputs, and that means that our root is not in this region. So, we repeat this process for the right of our root, and we see that output B times C is less than 0. Whichever side's product gives you less than 0, you know that your root lies in that direction. And that is really all there is to the bisection method. We just need to continue to cut our input range in half, determine which side's output is less than 0, and then we repeat this process until we find an acceptable level of error. You can measure the error through the absolute input of range 1 to range 2. As we know that our root will lie somewhere within this region, we're just not sure where. Although simple, the bisection method does have a few drawbacks, like all closed method nonlinear solvers. As you can imagine, defining the two initial ranges for which there is a root inside is not always simple. Additionally, you could have two roots within a single range, and this will cause you problems as you cannot converge to a single root when two exist. In the next video, I'll walk you through how to solve a bisection method problem by hand in Microsoft Excel, and probably a few programming languages as well, just to make sure that you fully know how to implement this method. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how to use the bisection method and to find the roots of a nonlinear function. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.